What is it about the chemistry that you and Rose have that works so well together on screen?
Well, thank you for saying it works well. I don't know. We really get on as friends, and we hit it off very quickly when we first met, and I think that reflects on screen, or hopefully it does, because we've got a good dialogue going off screen, so we kind of know how each other is going to react, and I don't know, it's lovely to have someone that you genuinely count as a friend working opposite.
What do you think it is about the chemistry that you and Kit have that works so well on screen?
I think it's a combination of things. Kit and I, we are very good friends, and we have similar senses of humour, which I think is an absolute blessing, because we kind of take the friendship that we have off screen and use it to bounce off one another when we are shooting together. And also, I think the way that it is written, I mean, the dialogue is so brilliant, and you do bounce off one another in that way, and then I feel that really resonates just because it's so intelligently written.
I fell in love in Iceland.
You fell in love in Iceland?
Yeah, yeah.
Who did you fall in love with?
I fell in love with my co-star.
This is Rose, who plays a Greek, who I've met, who is just the loveliest girl, and she could do so much better. Frankie...
He's got to work so closely with Kit. What makes him such a special performer?
The man is hugely talented and always has been, and he gives himself, I mean, he gives it 110%. So, yeah, he's phenomenally dedicated.
Kit, until recently, you lived with your best friend here in London, but you've just made the move. You've now moved in with your girlfriend.
Yeah, I've moved in with my other best friend, Rose, so I'm very, very happy, and it's... Oh. And it's going well. She's got all sorts of ideas for the house. So
is that the biggest difference? Is that the biggest difference that she wants to change?
Yeah,
stuff
I mean,
in the house?
I said to her, because she's moved into my house, and I said, look, darling, it's important that this is our space, that... You know, this feels like our space, that you haven't just moved into mine. Move anything you want around, change anything, chuck anything out. And I went to the shops, and I came back, and I said, so what did you decide? And she looked up and went, we're moving the kitchen downstairs.
And you were like, no, I meant a chair.
Yeah. So you, for those who don't know, you met Kit Harington on the show. You guys are engaged.
We
yes,
are.
Congratulations.
We are. Thank you very much. Thank you.
So,
it is. It's lovely.
You are, now you're in a situation where he's on Game of Thrones and
yes.
He is getting, do you try to get information from him?
No.
Okay.
I mean, talk about being an avid fan. I obviously am of The Good Wife, but with Game of Thrones, I'm like the rest of the world. I'm waiting for the new and final season.
I know, heartbreaking.
Obviously, to come out heartbreaking.
I don't know what I'm going to do.
Oh,
yeah.
God, what are we going to do?
I don't know.
But I remember kind of like over in the summer just gone, obviously the new episodes for the final season were coming through onto his iPad. And I mean, I can read his facial expressions.
Yeah.
I don't want to know anything that's going on like within his eyes or anything like that. So I send him packing. I kind of like boot him out so that he can go to the coffee
shop. Oh, so you won't let him even read it in front of you?
Absolutely not. No, because I'll know. I'll be able to gauge.
Gotcha.
Like if he like stiffens, then I know that someone's dead. And then I'm like, no, I don't. And then my mind goes off.
By the way,
I
don't want to ruin it for you. Someone's gonna be
you
dead.
Think?
Yeah.
I was like, I'm sorry to keep banging on about Rose, but I was giving her a kiss like when we were at the airport yesterday, and she's leaving for months. And this guy walks up, and I went, no, no, go away, turn around, walk away. Not a good time. Yeah.
I just wanted to ask you if you get distracted working with Kit Harington because he's so hot.
Oh, my. Do I get distracted? No, I don't. I'm incredibly professional. Professional. No, do you know what? He's a wonderful man. He really is. And so we have a lot of fun together, kind of like doing our scenes. So it's enjoyable.
Last season, this is of course, you, your lover in the earlier in the season is Rose Leslie. Ygritte, who is now your lovely wife. You guys met and got married right there. Fantastic. And I bring this up besides to congratulate you, to also to remind the audience here that last season, I understand that you told your wife how that season ended.
Yeah.
And then she was very angry that you told her.
She asked, like...
No, wait a second. I didn't hear that part. She said, how does it end? You told her?
Yeah, she asked, and I kind of said, you don't want to know. And she's like, no, I do want to know. Tell me. And I was like, you really don't want to know. And so I went, all right, well, basically, the Night King gets an ice dragon, and he, sorry for anyone who hasn't seen it. And he destroys the wall and the army of the undead come rushing through and it ends there. And she looked at me like... and then, like, was like, how dare you? You asked, and then she didn't talk to me for, like, 2 days or something.
I mean, you and your boyfriend, Kit, both actors, so yes. How do you work seeing each other? Is that difficult? You're different countries?
And yes.
Always on different projects?
I think it's a kind of embarrassment of riches, I suppose, whereby if both of us are working, then that's, you know, that's a lovely thing to be involved and to be busy. But, yes, I suppose you make it work. FaceTime is a must.
Got a very big, phone bill.
Yes, exactly.
I loved working with Rose, like, separately from our relationship or us being married, I think one of my fondest working relationships was with her.
Meeting Kit Harington for the first time, back in season two, he's a lovely man. He really is, very charming, very funny, and so that, you know, there was no awkwardness going on there. There was, you know, there was a good dialogue going off screen and obviously on screen, and so no, he made it very easy.
Excellent.
Yeah.
I got to ask you, the one of the most famous lines involving you in the show is, "You know nothing, Jon Snow." Is that the line that people yell to you all the time when you're on the street, or?
Yeah, and my wife is Rose, so we get doubly yelled at. You know,
it's exactly. Do people try to sneak it into conversation with you? Like, by the way, you know nothing, Jon Snow.
Yeah, I mean, the worst was my like, because I hate it. Like, I hate it when people say it.
Yeah,
and my brother managed to get it into the end of my best man speech.
That's what brothers are for.
It was quite sweet, actually. He said, but looking at the woman you're marrying, it shows you do know something, Jon Snow.
Ah,
this is sweet.
Hey, good on you. Yeah. Good on you, brother.
This seems like a very cruel prank that... This was April Fool's.
This was April Fool's. This was last year.
Last year's April Fool's.
Yeah.
So your lovely fiancé, Kit, did this to you. You opened up.
Did.
This is your refrigerator.
This is our refrigerator back at home in London. And bearing in mind, I had just wrapped from season one of The Good Fight. So I had been in New York for about 6 months. We hadn't spent that a lot of time together. And then I go home, and then the bastard puts this in the fridge. Horrible.
Did you fully scream?
I fully screamed.
Yeah.
Oh, I fully screamed. So basically, there's this whole big thing with the Brita filter. So I basically had ordered a Brita filter the day before, and I was very excited about its arrival. And so kind of like went downstairs to the fridge, and I was getting ready to kind of like have my glass of water for the first one of the day. And I was chatting to him over there, and I don't remember him kind of holding up a phone because he took a video of the whole thing. And I thought that he was kind of like texting, but still, you know, speaking to me. And then as I then turn my attention back to the fridge, I see this terrifying head staring back at me. And I don't necessarily recognize that it's him, but I just know that somebody is just bloodied in my hair, like in my fridge, hairy and oh, God.
You're married to Rose Leslie, one of your co-stars on the show, and who's fantastic. And she was here last year and said you pulled a very cruel, and the audience agreed with her that it was a very cruel April Fool's Day joke, which is she opened the refrigerator and you had that there.
Yeah. Yeah.
So did you back off April Fool's, or did you do something... do you do no pranks a year after that, or do you try something else?
See, I started strong.
Yeah.
The amount of props at my disposal has diminished.
Of course, sure.
This year was... I did pull a April Fool's on her while we were out here, and it was the most... I'm aware this is the most first world April Fool's before I tell this story, but she, I didn't know what to do. She has a favorite almond milk. She won't drink any other almond milk. So I just wrote an article about how this company that makes her favorite almond milk was going under because of Brexit. Now this backfired because she immediately rang my PA and got her to bulk order this almond milk with my credit card. So I ended up spending 150 quid on almond milk.
One of my favorite questions ever. And he says, can you get Kit Harington to make a cameo on the show?
I will absolutely try to get Kit to come onto the show, 100%. Michael, of course. Of course. Exactly.
But no, how's he doing tonight?
He's doing very well, thank you. Yeah, he's doing very well.
Rose. Yeah. My wife, Rose, inspires me every day.